And I don't think, I know why the public doesn't know what to do, because I don't know what to do. It's faced with this level of just foaming at the mouth criminality. What do you think we should do? And what are they thinking as there's a total resistance forming against them?
Well, listen, if I had a battle plan, and you're right, a lot of people don't know what to do, and it's no fault of theirs. It's just so much. You're being hit on 30 different fronts. You know, to steal a line from the left, they're 30-front war, and they do this intentionally. You know, the Cloward-Piven model, just overload the system. Here's what you do. Number one, we have to build public pressure. I say that a lot because I get to the question all the time. You know, do you support Obama's impeachment? And I tell people, frankly, no, you haven't won the public case. And people say, what do you think, he hasn't broken laws? No, that's not what I'm saying. What I'm trying to tell you, folks, we have not built the public case yet. You were talking about a process, a legal process. It's like an indictment. That's what impeachment is. It's like an indictment for the president. You then have to try the case. You don't indict a case, you're not going to win. You don't. We haven't built the public pressure. That's number one. How do we do that? So here's the battle plan. We have got to find more whistleblowers. We have to find people on the inside, like me, willing to speak out and say, hey, folks, this is not right. And right now, what I don't understand, Alex, is where are the people in the DOJ, the FBI agents within the DOJ administrative staff coming out and saying, hey, this IRS thing, we were sending, you know, they were sending confidential donor information to the DOJ. Where's the person saying, hey, I was the one who had sent, this isn't right, we got to change this? Where are the IRS agents speaking out and saying, hey, when I swore my oath, Alex, it was to the Constitution, not to anything else. You know, where are these folks? You know, and the third part of this process, so public pressure, you know, getting people on the inside to speak out. But the third part is we have to build an electoral presence, too. It's not just good enough anymore to vote for Republicans. Frankly, it's useless. It's almost destroying the cause because we get these squishes in there. They don't do anything, and then they tarnish the brand and make it even worse. It's time to start voting for liberty-oriented candidates who you hold to account. Don't put it, you know, don't make a golden calf out of anyone. We hold to account, but you can at least trust that they can talk the talk and walk the walk. You know, when they get out there and they shake your hand, they can look you in the eye, and you believe these people, they understand what's going on with the Fed. They understand, you know, Cloward Pivot. They understand what's going on with why the Constitution was written as a document of negative powers by the government, what they can't do to you. You know, that's the kind of folks. We get through that three-step process. Eventually, we'll have something to do, but you know, you can't just say, oh, we got to impeach the president. Okay, you're going to lose, just like you did with Clinton, and then you know what happens? You make him more powerful. I mean, we have to have an actual tactical battle plan going forward, and just throwing out stuff like that without an actual plan to implement it is just a suicide plan.
Well, I agree with you, and you're actually technically right. As you know, the House indicts the president, the Senate then tries him. And so you've got to actually go after him with more than just a intern. They wanted to go after him on the intern because it was isolated to just lying to a grand jury. It was isolated to only one issue that protected the political class. The truth is, if the Republican leadership wanted to go after him for Solyndra, or wanted to go after him for Benghazi or Fast and Furious or any of it, they could prove it and bring him down. But there's not the moral will, because it's a bunch of establishment rhinos. But as they get replaced, as we're about to see in this midterm election, as we just saw this amazing primary win by David Brat, I'd like you to speak to that, because bottom line, the Democrats are going for the full takeover right now. What's your take on Brat? B, and Republicans winning primaries all over the place as well, what do you think the establishment's going to do to try to counter that?
Oh, let me tell you something. Brat was a wake-up call, not just for our side, the grassroots liberty lovers out there, but you don't think they're going to take this lying down. This is like a UFC match where you think you're going to kick the guy's butt. All of a sudden, he wallops you in the face, and you're like, oh, boy, this isn't going to be as easy a fight as I thought. The establishment, I'm in D.C. all the time, meeting with grassroots warriors over there, doing God's work. They know for a fact that the establishment's now rearming again. They're not going to be, and let me give you a quote from one of them, they're not going to be surprised again. So they are understanding that the people knocking on the doors and waving the signs are not with them. So they're going to go out and they're going to try and do what they always do. They're going to try to buy elections. They're going to try and put people like me down. They're going to try and put Chris McDaniel down. you know, there's a junk car in Tennessee. They're going to try and put folks down. They're going to try to suppress them because that's what they do. That's all they can do, Alex. They lost the people a long time ago. You know, there's an insurrection going on in the Republican Party right now. And it's just hysterical, too, how, like, the left, you know, they just go along with their candidate randomly. Like, you put a D in front of their name, and, oh, it's all good. It doesn't even matter what they stand for. And the media is in such a tizzy because they can't believe the fact that there are liberty-loving folks out there that actually care about liberty. They're like, what do you mean they didn't elect Eric Cantor? That's a surprise. He was their leader. No, he ain't my leader. I'm not. I don't subscribe to what I don't worship Golden Calf, okay? He did not stand up for the people. He's not out there shaking the hands. He was not standing for the cause of liberty, and people didn't get behind him. I don't know why the media is so surprised. I think they're surprised because they don't have the values we do, and they don't understand that liberty actually matters because they believe in a redistributionist state run by the bureaucratic elites who sit there with their bow ties and tell us all what to do, why we all go broke, and they enrich themselves at our expense. Well, not no more. Those days are over. I'm not subscribing to that. Not one more day.
Well, that brings me to my next point. We saw the tragic two police officers and a citizen killed. And if you even believe the official story, because who knows with the establishment these days, you got a guy with crazy Joker videos that looks completely mentally ill, into death cults with his girlfriend, just like you've got these other kids stabbing, you know, little girls to death because, you know, there's another comic book character they like. And they're trying to blame Ronald Reagan and Rand Paul and me and saying we're responsible when all I ever say is we don't want a violent revolution. We want a peaceful restoration. And I'm really concerned that Obama came out. It was on CBS 2 days ago. But here's the headline. Obama cites Australia's gun confiscation program as example for U.S. And yeah. Now, if they actually try to have an executive order on some type of gun confiscation, say, of Semi-Autos, and if they try to send out armored vehicles like they're doing in California to confiscate guns, I mean, this is a powder keg. And I think if I was Obama and I wanted to take over, I would try to stir up the libertarian constitutional movement and try to push people into a corner. I mean, we see these headlines about veterans are the number one terror threat with no evidence of that, no crime statistics to show that. What I'm getting at is, it looks like they're trying to start some type of civil war.
Well, remember, the only way to get you in America, which is generally a country of good people, generally, I mean, we've been the most philanthropic country in the history of Earth, you know, to really hate their neighbor and to vote against them is to demonize them and put them in the boxes, union, non-union, black, white, Hispanic, immigrant, man, woman, war on women. That's what the left does. Remember, the Republican Party generally, at least the good ones, they don't do that. They run on, let's cut your taxes, let's defeat Obamacare, that kind of stuff. The left doesn't do that. The left runs on this agenda of, this guy's not you, therefore you should not like him. Vote for me, I'll keep the not you away from
they
you.
They vote on class warfare. They vote on division. They vote on racial strife. They are not liberals. I mean, I've got to say it. I mean, the Democratic Party is a pack of mentally ill criminals. Now, I'm not talking about their grassroots people. A lot of them mean well. But I've got to say, when you look at MSNBC and these people, they know exactly what they're doing.
Yeah, I'm glad you said it, because I knock on a lot of doors out there, and I knock on Democrats with high voter scores, people who show up. And a lot, believe me, a lot of them are frustrated, too. They're Democrats because their parents are. I mean, my mother's a Democrat, and she'll never vote Democrat again. She was a JFK Democrat. You know, those days are over. But, you know, you brought up an interesting point, too, about them, you know, pinpointing people like yourself and other talk radio hosts. Oh, look what you guys did. But keep in mind, Alex, think of that. This is the hypocritical fraud these people in the media are. They never mentioned Floyd Corkins. You know, Floyd Corkins, who shot up the Family Research Council. And he said
he did it because of the Southern Poverty Law Center.
Right, exactly. Yeah, I mean, it clear as day, the Southern Poverty Law Center, the biggest leftist kooks you've ever seen, who if you say anything about anything, if you are pro-life, you're a hate group, according to these nuts, this guy said, I read about the Family Research Council and their stance on gay marriage, and I didn't like. So he basically shot the place up. The media almost completely ignores the story, and yet you get these two psychopaths in Nevada, who apparently were even kicked off that ranch. We were too nutty for the ranch out there, too. And all of a sudden, every conservative who's ever preached liberty and low taxes is somehow related. I mean, think about the utter stupidity of that. But that's the media. And I'll tell you what, I just ignore it. I know it's hard because they don't like you because you do something that scares them and that commands attention. They don't want that. See, the media wants to monopolize the megaphone. And you got this guy coming up behind them saying, wait, I can do that, too. And they don't like that. So they have to say, oh, be careful. They're dangerous. Don't look at these guys. But they don't admit their own role with Corkin, you know, Jared Lee Loeffner. You know, even going back to Oswald. Oswald was a leftist.
They're even trying now in the news. In fact, I'm looking for the article right here to basically say that David Bratt is weird because he says Hitler could happen again. Well, I mean, of course tyranny can happen again. It happens most of the time. So I mean, again, it's like Obama saying and Biden and all these speeches and Kerry, come back to government. Believe in it again like it's a religion.
Right.
Trust it. It's the answer. Don't listen to people that warn about tyranny. Well, that's what America's all about.
Yeah. Oh, they'll pick Brad apart. Anything he said, because they are so desperate to make this story go away. Because what bothers them, Alex, more than anything we've spoken about in this phone call, is a grassroots insurrection against big government Republicans and Democrats. That drives them nuts because the fact is, and you know this as well as I do, there's some people in the Republican Party that are friends to big government Democrats.
Oh, yeah.
They all sell out to the same
John Boehner?
Yeah, these people are not leaders. They just sell out to a different golden calf they kneel before. Either way, you've sold out. They're not bedrocked in real values. The fact that a grassroots rebellion in Virginia 7 could unseat the second most powerful man in Congress. Think about that. With no money, nothing, peanuts, a tip in a restaurant in donation terms for fundraising, that they could unseat him by double digits. These guys are running in fear. They will do anything to discredit Brad. You're going to see these stories every day. You know, Brad pulled a girl's hair once in eighth grade. You're going to see it every day. And it just
remember the Democrats with Rand Paul when he won the primary?
Oh.
They went out and dressed up as hayseeds and said racist things on TV, and it turned out they actually worked for the Democratic Party.
Oh, that's all that's all they have, though. They don't have anything else. You know what bothers them most about Brad? He gets up there and he actually understands how the biggest form of taxation this country's ever seen is the Fed. He goes up there and explains, hey, folks, if you have a dollar and I tax you 25 cents, I've taken 25 cents. You have 75 cents left. But if I go out there and I give you a dollar, right, and I tax away the value of it via inflation and you only get, it's only worth 10 cents, I've taxed you 90 cents, whether you know it or not. And he explains this in common sense economic terms. The left is like, wait, we can't have that information out there, folks. Information is dangerous unless we can lie to people about it.
Well, Dan, I got to say it. I mean, you're super articulate. You're a smart guy. Your book's already a bestseller. I mean, you would be perfect in Congress, and I don't want to have to knock on wood here. But, I mean, you were telling me during the break when we first got you on that things are going really well, but they could pull a lot of tricks. People need to get behind you in Maryland. They need to get behind every other true liberty-based candidate. And people could just hear what you're speaking. You're a whistleblower. You exposed Obama. I know you've gone through a lot of harassment. People need to pray for you and your family. Have you gotten any more harassment?
It's always one of our security cameras mess with. It's always something. It's always there. And I just roll with it. You know, we all have to make sacrifices. I'm a believer in the second creation, and you pay your dues here. So I'm not worried about it. The fight's the fight. People have no one's as powerful as, George III, right? So I'm not that worried about it.
You know, it's funny that I go through some harassment as well, and I don't know what it is. You don't like to talk about it. It's just kind of like, yeah, it's going on. It's like you don't even want to give it attention that they're doing it. But it's important to show what scum these people are.
You know what? It is, and I don't want, because I think it incentivizes more of it. And I have two daughters. But secondly, I'm 6'1", 215 pounds. I grew up boxing and wrestling and Brazilian jiu-jitsu. I was fighting with the Gracies when no one knew who they were. So I got a pretty thick skin. I got the facial scars and broken nose to prove it. So I'm not really worried about these bow tie wearing foie gras.
No, I get it. Absolutely. You're calling their bluff. Dan Bongino, Bongino.com. Folks can follow him on Facebook, going there and following it through. Thank you for the time. And I can't wait to call you Congressman here on the broadcast and turn this country around. Thank you so much for your courage.
Hey, got it, Alex. Thanks.
All right, I'm going to say it. There goes Congressman Dan Bongino. Folks, I'm telling you. They're going to try to pull a false flag to blame the Tea Party. Get ready for that.
We're on the march. The Empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.